What we found about 10 years ago now is that stem cells make proteins unusually slowly. Stem cells are the proverbial tortoise. They believe that slow and steady wins the race. And like the tortoise, stem cells are long-lived. Other cells, well, they make protein fast, and they are the proverbial hare. They live fast and die young. Now, why do stem cells need to make protein so slowly? Well, it turns out by making protein slowly, they're making it more accurately. They're making fewer errors. So you can think of when you're making protein very quickly, you're going to start to put them together in ways that aren't always the best. And when that happens, what we call this is sort of protein misfolding. And these misfolded proteins, you can really think of as the trash of a cell. The cell doesn't want these. Why? One, they don't work the way that they're supposed to work. Two, if you make all this trash, it starts to pile up. And that can start to affect all sorts of other processes in the cell. And so stem cells really care about this. They do not want trash to pile up. They are in it for the long haul. Now, this process is so important that stem cells don't only count on making less mistakes when they make protein, they also have a completely different plan to deal with those mistakes and get rid of those bad proteins or protein trash. So stem cells take that protein trash, which is shown here in red, and they try to consolidate it in one area of the cell. And then what they do is they build a cage around it. That's shown in green. But this sort of cage of protein trash isn't just a protein landfill in the stem cells. Turns out it's actually a recycling plant. Stem cells preferentially use a very specialized recycling pathway to break down and reuse all of those resources. Because remember, stem cells need to care about sustainability. They are in it for the long haul. Now, what happens when we age? Well, these systems start to fall apart. And this protein trash starts to accumulate and pile up in our aging stem cells. This stresses out our stem cells and makes them start to malfunction as we get older. But there's some good news. The stem cells, they don't go down without a fight. They sound the alarm and they call in reinforcements. Meet heat shock factor 1, or HSF1, which I think of as a superhero protein that gets called into action in stressed and aging stem cells. And you can see it enter the nucleus of the cell where it interacts with the DNA, and it launches a program to help reduce protein trash and to help stem cells cope with this accumulation of these misfolded proteins. So here's what happens. Right? We have young stem cells that do a good job at keeping this protein trash at bay. Those stem cells have lots of energy and lots of potential to regenerate our tissues for a long period of time. As we age, that protein trash builds up in those stem cells and their power is lost. But our aging stem cells call in the reinforcements, they activate this HSF1 superhero, and they're able to partially reduce the amount of trash that's building up and maintain more of this regenerative potential. So is this the answer? Do we just need to supercharge HSF1 and now we can reverse the effects of aging? Well, I hate to break it to you, but there's a catch. Stem cells aren't the only cells that like HSF1. Cancer cells really like HSF1. What we found is that HSF1 boosts the expansion of precancerous stem cells and supports the development of cancer as we get older. This is the ultimate catch-22. Stem cells are fighting the forces of aging to stay fit and keep regenerating our tissues. But to do that, they have to elevate our risk of getting cancer. The stem cells are literally robbing Peter to pay Paul. What I've realized is that the answer is right in front of us. The blueprint for the fountain of youth is already pre-wired into long-lived stem cells. Stem cells know they don't want to have to deal with that trash and that stress, and that they know that calling in reinforcements can only do so much. The stem cells' secret to longevity is preventing the production and pileup of protein trash. And so we're taking that blueprint and we're trying to better it. How do we make stem cells even better at preventing this trash? Well, we've taken all sorts of approaches and we're starting to test it in the lab right now. And the results are amazing. So we have young stem cells. They have their regenerative potential, but eventually exhaust. We have old stem cells that start to accumulate trash. They call in reinforcements. They can partially block the problem, but you know, like we talked about, this can lead to cancer. Well, we've made old super stem cells. These stem cells are even better than normal stem cells at preventing the buildup of trash. They're less stressed out, and they live longer. But it's not just about stem cell fitness, right? Our goal is to prevent disease. Is that something we can really do by keeping our stem cells fit? Well, we're working on this right now, and I've never been more excited about what we're discovering. So let me share one piece of that with you today. This is the spleen from a healthy mouse. What we can do is to introduce a cancer-causing mutation that drives a very aggressive form of blood cancer. Within weeks, you can see the effect on the mouse's spleen. When we do the same thing in our mice that carry these super stem cells, we don't see that cancer coming. And so maybe we have found the fountain of youth. Maybe it really does exist within each of our stem cells and providing us the path forward, that preventing the accumulation of trash is the key to long health and long life. As Benjamin Franklin said, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure.